Today we're going to make a vegetarian roast Christmas dinner, and this is what you need. What we're going to do, we're going to do some carrots, we're going to do some Brussels sprouts. We're only going to do a one portion on here at this time. We've got some commercial chicken style slices. You can do stuffing with them, which we've got. They also do a beef style, which you could do with Yorkshire pudding, or they do a turkey style, which you could do with stuffing. And if slices aren't your thing, a couple of good vegetarian sausages would do well, wouldn't they? And a roast.
Would, yeah.
Okay. We've also got some commercial roast potatoes. Watch for some of them because they're done in goose fat, so you need to make sure they're vegetarian, usually done in sunflower oil. And for a gravy, we like this one, the Bisto Best caramelised onion gravy, and it's in the glass jar. The cardboard one we didn't really rate, so we go for this.
You didn't get on with that, did you?
Not at all. Yeah. No. So what we're going to do is get these prepared, and then we'll get back to you. Of course, as well, you need a steamer. We have one of these. We've got the two cullingers in and the base unit, because we don't boil any veg in here.
Nope.
Anyway. Okay, so we'll prepare these, and I'll get back to you. Right, we've prepared and sliced your carrots and washed them. Cut them into thin slices like that. With the Brussels again, take off the outer coating that's mucky or whatever. Just cross them at the bottom and cut the bottom bit off, and then we'll just put them in the colander. With the commercial sage and onion stuff, and we've just put a knob of butter in because it makes it taste a lot better. With the tray with the roast potatoes, we've just greased that with olive oil. What we're going to do now is put the potatoes and the stuffing in. It's on 180. All your instructions for your cooking is usually on your packet, but sometimes it's better to judge it yourself because you can get a better taste. So they've gone in now. They're about 25 minutes, but we're going to turn the potatoes over halfway through. We're going to get a steamer on now, get it on a good jet. Turn it on. You have it about halfway along. It takes about 20-25 minutes. Put your Brussels in the bottom because they're harder to cook, and your carrots at the top. Pop your lid on. When you put your water in your steamer, don't put it too high that it'll go into your veg, because you don't want it in your veg, you want it a bit lower. So that's about inch and a half maybe to top. You don't want it to boil dry either, as my mum did before when she was on the cider. As you can see, it's a bit black in there, so we don't have the homemade cider out for it, I mean. Right, so that's going on there, and we will give that about 20-25 minutes, and then we'll test them and show you how stressed them are they right. Okay, we'll do the gravy later. We'll get back to you when this is starting cooking. Okay. Right, this meal's nearly ready now, so I'm going to just get my gravy ready as well. You can make the gravy as strong as you want. I've used 3 teaspoons into about half a cup of water, because it's only just a one portion here. And I'm going to just pop it in a pan as well, so that you can keep it warm as you want it. Okay, so just give us 2 minutes and we'll go to a veg. We'll see you in a minute. Okay. Potatoes and your stuffing are done now. And so are your carrots and your Brussels, and you want the carrots so that they go in but they don't fall apart. And same again with your Brussels, they go in but they're not going to drop apart, yeah? Okay, so what we're going to do is get these out. And if your gravy's bubbling in your pan and it's still warm, this is our new plate as well for the Christmas plate. See, if you do it in olive oil, they don't stick. You see, they're sliding across, where normally you're peeling them off, aren't you? So we'll just get a few of these on. How many would you like?
That'll be enough for me.
Enough, yeah?
Yeah.
And I'll get some stuffing out as well. That enough?
You can do us plenty of that.
All right.
I like the stuffing.
Okay. Then, pop that on there, and we're going to put some butter out in a dish as well, so they can put their own butter on and their own pepper. And then you can just serve, keep your gravy on last. Let's have a look. Get a different spoon for that. Slotted spoon, get your plate again. Well, you have to tell me how much carrots you want as well.
That'll be about right.
Yeah?
Yeah, that'll do.
Shall we? Yeah. I'm going to do it for serve, aren't I? Okay. So I'll put a little bit more and then you can have what you want. I'll do it that way. And then, the You're not all over at Brussels, are you?
No, I've a bit of a problem, the sprouts.
Well, I'll put them on and we can take them off.
To prove a point, I'll have one.
I will have these because I like some sprouts. There you go. And then, get your slices out, which have been in the fridge. And above them on as well. You can have as many as you want of these.
I'll have plenty of those.
Yep. And we'll do that. Split them up first and then they're not stuck together. I just do for now, like that.
Yep.
And then I'm going to get your gravy. How much gravy would you like? And where do you want your gravy? On this one?
Yeah, I'll go with them.
All your spuds or not? All your potatoes?
Spuds, yeah.
Yep. Like that. And you can
good.
Put as much as you want after.
Looking
good. That is pretty much it. And then if you take the butter dish out and the pepper pot, then they can serve themselves. Okay? Oh, if you want more information about this, refer to the blog. And we've got it all written down what we do for the full menu.